Hi, I'm State Senator Linda Evans Parlette. This happens to be the third week of the legislative session, and we are all hoping that means Democrats, Republicans, House members, and Senate members that the session truly will end on March 10th. Time will tell. Right now, we are in the process where we have bills that are being heard in committees. We hear the testimony and try to change them, to improve them, and then pass them out of committee, either to go on to the Ways and Means Committee, which I sit on if they have fiscal issues, meaning they cost money, or straight to the Rules Committee, and then eventually we will be voting right here in the Senate chambers on those bills, because the last day to get bills out of the House of Origin is February 17th at 5 o'clock p.m. Today I testified in support of a piece of legislation that I've sponsored, Senate Bill 6440, having to do with toxic flame retardants. Very, very controversial subject. Normally this piece of legislation goes in front of the Environment Committee. This year it went in front of the Healthcare Committee, and it has been debated for years. Whether or not this bill moves forward, it's hard to say, but the ultimate goal is to make sure that we don't have toxic flame retardant chemicals in baby blankets and things like that. We'll see if this bill moves forward. Hearings are also being scheduled for two of the bills that I've really spent a long time on, having to do with the health of our forests. As you know, in North Central Washington, in 2012, we had a catastrophic fire. We had catastrophic fires again in 2014, and again just last year, 2015. We had 30 days of smoke in 2012, 2014, 2015. So much smoke that in the middle of August, you could not see across Lake Chelan. That's amazing. One of the bills has to do with smoke management. I say, how do you want your smoke? A small amount of smoke when you do prescribed burns, or 30 days of smoke when these forest fires get totally out of control? That will be a controversial bill, but it's time we have that discussion. The other bill has to do with strategies for wildfires prevention called prescribed burns and other forest health treatment. I learned from the new forest supervisor from the Okanagan-Wenatchee Forest Service that Washington State does less prescribed burns than Idaho, Oregon, California. He came from Flagstaff, Arizona. Why is this happening? Well, that's the purpose of this bill, to look at this policy to see if we can change things. After 3 years, almost 3 years in a row of fires, it doesn't do any good to keep sending money out and doing the same things we've been doing over and over. That bill probably will be controversial too, but I had many firefighters from the local area in my office today, and the management too, to talk about these issues. And hopefully out of those hearings that will occur next week, we will improve the bills and they will move forward. Another bill that I sponsored last year, and it passed the Senate but not the House, we voted on right here in the Senate chambers. That bill was Senate Bill 5779. We passed it over to the House again with a 49-0 vote. What that would do would allow our regional support networks to deal with mental health issues. If there aren't enough beds at Eastern State Hospital, but one of the other regional support networks has available beds, whether that's Spokane or Yakima, we can send people to those areas and do it at a reduced cost than if we had to send them to Eastern State Hospital. It would allow our RSNs to work together. I hope that bill makes it to the governor's office. So this week, we've had a very busy week. Lots of people visiting, especially cities and towns. I spoke this morning at the Association of Washington Cities conference and had many people from my district there. I would like to introduce you to my page for the week. This is Emma Bruner. I've had the privilege of knowing her parents for a long time. I actually was at a Rotary meeting and her dad was there, and he said, guess what? My daughter's gonna be there next week. The PAGE program is a wonderful program. I still have openings. You have to be between the ages of 14 and 16. You get to come to Olympia, go through a little orientation on a Sunday, and then leave on Friday evening. And you get to be all over this Capitol doing errands. Emma today was right here up above in the Senate chambers. Some students came in and she got to speak to them. That's pretty awesome, something that most PAGEs don't get to do. So until next week, thank you for the honor of representing you again. State Senator Linda Evans Parlette. Representing you.